Are you trying to place an order on DHgate and getting this error message as well as this one? Well, if so, your girl got you. I'm going to show you how to get past that. Stay tuned. So here I'm using my laptop, but you can use your phone, so don't fret. Just stay tuned. Log into your account. Click the help button at the top. Look over to your left and look for the option that says payment. Click that button and then it should extend out. And then go down to the payment verification and click that as well. Remember I told you if you're using your phone, that's cool. DHgate got you. They gave you both options. So whichever one you using, select that. I'm using a PC, so we're going to click that. Okay, so if you're trying to place an order and then you get, please click here to activate credit card payment method. You're going to click here. If you placed the order and they canceled it and it says the transaction could not be processed, click here, click that button. Now, sometimes calling your credit card or debit card company and let them know that you're making a foreign or international purchase could solve the problem. But if it does not, you will have to submit payment verification. There's four different types you can provide, which is credit card photos, your payment record, authorization number, and the billing statement. I recommend sending as much as you can. You will just upload them because it will help the process be successful. So once all the information is submitted, you can check the status using this link that I'll provide in the description box down below. All the information you uploaded will be found on this page. It also will have like a tracker showing you the progress of the verification. So once you handle that, there's only two things that can happen. Either the verification is going to pass or is going to reject. If it passed, then you're good to go. If it rejects, that means there's more information that they need, something that they could not make out of, something that you were missing. So then you would press that modify button and submit whatever else they're asking for. So this is how it would look if you're using your cell phone. It's very similar to the other steps. You'll log in into the app. There's three parallel lines in the left-hand corner. You'll click that. You have selections drop down. You'll click payment verification. At that point, you'll see which credit card it is that needs to be verified. You'll select that. They're going to want you to upload the same information as I mentioned earlier in the video. I also meant to mention they only need the first six of your credit card number and the last four digits of the number of the card. The rest can be covered up. They also will need the CVV, the three numbers on the back of the card for security purposes. And you should receive the verification result via email or check your DHgate inbox messages. I've had many ask me what payment method does DHgate accept, and there they are right there. Now, if all else fails, you need to take your behind up there to the help center, click on customer service, click on contact a live agent. Provide you with different methods of contacting somebody that actually works for DHgate. Your girl don't work for DHgate, boo. This is just some information I found out from experience, from doing my research, and decided to help out and share it with you. So if it doesn't work, don't come for me. I'm just a messenger. Your girl do have a playlist that consists of all things Aliexpress and DHgate related, so be sure to check that out. I want to thank you so very much for taking the time out to watch this video. Hopefully it helped you out. Until next time, later.